Hi students, how are you? This is M. Don Bosco, SA Bioscience, GHS Shantinagar in Khammam town. Today we are going to discuss about the diversity in the living organism and classification. This is our fifth chapter in the ninth class, biology. In this chapter, in the previous classes, we are already learned about some of the important things. What is the classification? What is the important of the classification? We did some experiments also, some project works also before the beginning of this chapter. What type of projects we did? We collect the different plant leaves and different stems and different flowers and different all different types of things we are collected and observed the all these things, and also we are classified these all the leaves also and flowers also. In the basis of that classes, today we are going to discuss about the what is the classification, what is the need of classification, what is the importance of the classification, who was the firstly classified in the organisms, and all these things today we are going to learn. First of all, we are going to learn this chapter and this some matter. What is the need of the classification? It is help us to the makes more focus to handle the huge population of each organisms, and also it is help us to study the organism in the proper and systematic manner. So the classification help us to study the organism in the proper and systematic manner, and also this classification helps and also it give us to the better knowledge of understanding of the organism and their study, and also this classification helps in the understandings of the relationship of many organisms and their independence, and this classification also help us to make the comparison of each organisms. It gives us also the idea of evolution. It gives us an idea of evolution. That means how the organisms have evolved in this manner. And also it gives us some more information about the how the organisms have the evolved in this nature. So today we are learning about the all these things. That is the main important of the need of classification. The second one is all the living things are classified in the same manner, or all these things are classified and categorized on the basis of their structure and function. So first of all, the scientists did the so much work and classified the different organisms in the basis of their structure and their functions. Okay, that means the characteristics that come into the existence earlier are likely to be more, and basic of characteristics that have come into the existence later. This means the classification of the life forms are closely related to the their evolution. So classification is the play the role important of the evolution. So evolution is the process of acquiring the characteristics or changes also. History of the classification. What is the history of the classification? Is there any history in the classification?
Yeah.
So many history are there in the classification. In India, the classification have been the basis of the studies in the medicine in the first and the second century of
AD.
And also, at the one of the Indian famous scientists, Charaka and Shashru, they had classified the different plants on the basis of their medicinal importance. Then after, the another famous scientist in India, Parashura. Yes. Parashura, one of the another famous Indian scientists, and also he was the classified the several land plants in the some particular character basis, and he observed the so many plants he classified in the basis of medicinal and structural and functional also, and he documented in his observations and his classification in the book of Vruksha Ayurveda. Yes, this is the book who wrote the Parashura about the classification. Now let us study how the biologists from 16th century have been trying to classify the diverse organisms so far. So many biologists, they are classified in the all living organisms in different classification. First of all, you see the Carolus Linnaeus. He was in 1735 to 58. He was classified the all the living organisms into two kingdoms. There, one is the Vegetabilia, the other one is Animalia. Vegetabilia means all the living plants are classified into the, they are grouped into the one kingdom. This kingdom is Vegetabilia. The another kingdom, all the living animals, they are added into the another kingdom, which is the Animalia. Then in 1866, the another scientist, the Hacker, he was classified the all the these plants and animals and all the organisms into three kingdoms. They are, one is the Protista, the another one is the Plantae, third one is the Animalia. Then the another scientist, the Charter, he was in 1925, he was classified the living organisms into two empires. One is the prokaryote, the other one is the eukaryotes. Then the fourth one is Copeland. He was in 1938, he was classified the organisms into the four kingdoms. They are, one is the first one is the Monera, the second one is the Protista, third one is the Plantae, then fourth one is Animalia. Then the next one is an advanced classification. Who was classified? The scientist name was the Whittaker, Thomas Whittaker, classified the five kingdoms. That is, first one is Monera, and second one is Protista, third one is Plantae, fourth one is Fungi, fifth one is Animalia. After Whittaker, the Poussin et al. He was classified, the latest, he was classified the organisms into three kingdoms. One is the bacteria, another one is archaea, third one is eukarya. Last classification was done recently, it is 1998. Cavier and Smith, these two scientists are classified in the organisms into the six kingdoms. They are bacteria, protozoa, chromista, plantae, fungi, and animalia. All these scientists are classified in the organisms in different kingdoms and their different empires. All these classification was other in the different type of structure and different type of behavior and different type of their characteristics. Then and in 1970, the Carolus Linnaeus, he proposed the system that has dominated the classification of centuries. Then Linnaeus, he gave the organisms into the two names. First one is the genus, the second one is species. Yeah, example, the human name, the scientific name is Homo sapiens. Homo is the genus, the sapiens is species. Yes. Firstly, the Linnaeus was classified and he was give the two names of each organism, that is genus and species. This classification was called as the binomial nomenclature. Yes. Then he was grouped in the order of the different organisms in the different manner. Yes. Then the Linnaeus several genus, he was grouped in the genera. These genera grouped into the families, and these families grouped into the orders, the order grouped into the classes, the classes grouped into the phylum, and phylum grouped into the kingdom. Firstly, he was identified in the two kingdoms. They are Animalia and Plantae. All these terms like species and genus and families and order and classes and phylum, etc. They are defined by the Carolus Linnaeus on the basis of similarities and differences. Take a classification. In this classification, he proposed the five kingdoms. They are Monera, Protista, Plantae, and Fungi, and Animalia. The specific importance of the Whittaker classification is he specified the whether organisms opposed their true nucleus or not, that means prokaryote and eukaryote. He grouped the eukaryotic unicellular organisms are placed into the kingdom Protista. Yes. And the rest of the Plantae and Fungi and Animalia, rest of these kingdoms he placed into the and classified the general manner, that means basis of their appearing for the their food. So plants are generally we are already learned in the class 5th or 6th, plants are generally autotrophs, animals are heterotrophs. Okay, these five kingdoms were systematically, whose kingdom, Whittaker kingdom, was classified in the systematic mannerly, and this system was certainly an advance for all these previous systems. The new evidence and the new methods have shown that in his classification in the five kingdom system, it is, and also it is fails to the adequately capture what we know about the diversity of life. Microbial biologists, they are become aware of these Whittaker classifications and Whittaker limitations as they discovered the unicellular organisms. They discovered the internal structure and other characteristics from the traditional bacteria. They observed the different structure of the bacteria in the Whittaker classification. These bacteria, they have the specific structure in their DNA. Some bacteria are living in the hot temperature, which is called as the thermophilous bacteria. Some of the bacteria also are living there in the high salt in condition. These bacteria are called as the halophilous bacteria. Hierarchy of classification. In this classification, the starting from the grouping of living organisms into domains. Yes. In the hierarchy, the classification starts by the basis of the species. First of all, we see the definition of the species. What is the species? A species includes all organisms that are similar enough to interbreed and perpetuate to or even individual or reproduce. Now we see the hierarchy of the classification. The classifications start from the species. We are already learning about the species, the meaning of species. The species are grouped as the genus. These genes grouped into the family. The family is grouped into the order. Orders grouped into the classes. The classes grouped into the phylum. Phylum grouped into the kingdom. Kingdom grouped into the domain. Domain grouped into the line. This is the hierarchy of the classification. Tomorrow we are going to learn about the importance of each kingdom and their living organisms, and also we are going to learn about what type of organisms are grouped in the each kingdom.